Fibonacci retracement, support and resistance levels. So Fibonacci retracement levels can be used to identify potential reversal levels. And these are extremely powerful, and I recommend you use them in conjunction with, for example, the horizontal previous high and low levels, as I talked about in another video. But let's look at the most powerful Fibonacci retracement levels. And the most powerful Fibonacci retracement levels are the 61.8% level, the 50% level, and the 38.2% level. In this example, you can see that the numbers are 1, 0.5, 0.382, and 0. But basically, what you're looking for, as always, you want to trade in the direction of the trend. So when you have a higher low and a higher high, as the two first arrows here mark out, you draw the Fibonacci, and now you want to wait for price to come back to the 50% or the 38.2%. And when price touches these levels, you enter long. And you will often see that these levels are combined with the previous high level we talked about in another video. So this is so beautiful. You just trade like a stair step. Let's look at a real short example. This is the EURJPY, and as you can see here from the left, look to the left, you can see that we have a higher low, and when we get our higher high, we draw the Fibonacci from the high to the low, and we look to enter at the 50% level. And as you can see, the 50% here is also the previous high, so it's a good level, and you can put your target just above the previous high or at the previous high, depending on how aggressive you are. Let's look at a bearish example. We want a lower low and a lower high. And when we have that, we draw a Fibonacci and you get your levels and you enter at the 50% or the 38.2%. After you enter your trade, you put in your stop loss order and your target order at the previous low or lower, depending on how aggressive you are, and you wait for the trade to play out. Here's a bearish example in EURJPY 1 hour short. And as you can see, we have a lower low and a lower high. We draw Fibonacci. We want to enter at the Fibonacci retracement levels. When price comes up to that level, we enter our trades and we wait for price to take us to new lows. And as you can see here, it took some time before we finally broke that level. And an upgrade for you here is, you probably read that the more times a level is hit, the stronger it becomes. I found that that's not the case. The more times a level is tested, the higher probability it will fail.